Here's an awesome way to stop overfishing, guys. Let's just close the oceans. Easy peasy, right, guys? Hey Piscivores, Trace here for DNews. We are killing the oceans. In the middle of the last century, aggressive commercial fishing really hit the oceans hard, trying to get high protein fish into our diet. In 1989, 90 million metric tons of fish were taken from the ocean. Since that peak, the number of fish caught has decreased every year since. And not because we don't want more fish, but because they're simply not there. In the year 2000, the BBC assumed genetically farmed fish would be sustaining the world by 2025. That is not far from now. At the time, the United Nations estimated 70% of the world was threatened by overfishing. Then in 2003, the journal Nature estimated of the biomass of all the fish in the ocean, only 10% of all of that is left thanks to commercial fishing. It's sort of like we had 10 fish, and we ate 9 of them. So now what? At the moment, the international community has agreed to fish in seasons with catch quotas and minimum size limits with the hope that this would allow time for the fish to mature, spawn, and build the population back. Newsflash, it ain't working. Why? Because we're not really managing the fisheries at all. It's essentially a free-for-all once ships are in international waters. And according to the World Wildlife Federation, the global fishing fleet is 2 to 3 times larger than what the oceans can sustainably support. So what do we do? A new plan published in PLOS Biology has a pretty radical solution that they say will sustain the fish populations forever. Close the oceans. Okay, everybody, we had a good run. Close it up. We're done. Seriously though, close the oceans? Is this gonna work? According to the researchers' models, yeah. Not only will it work, but we would end up making money in the long run. Their plan is to close the high seas, which are real. This is not a pirate joke, it's a real thing. The United Nations Food and Agriculture Organization defined the high seas as international waters more than 200 miles from land. If you do the math, that's 64% of the ocean surface and 95% of its volume, all unfishable. Closed, but only for a few years. Then, when they're open again under new regulations, we can fish sustainably forever. Yeah, it sounds a little far-fetched. But last month, the director of international consulting firm McKinsey & Company said the exact same thing. He said, we are subsidizing the high seas fishing already, which increasingly is not a profitable enterprise. Ships just meander around the oceans looking for remaining populations. So if we designated the high seas as conservation areas, it would cost us on average $2 per person for everybody on the planet. But we'd get $4 back in the long run. Once populations of fish rebounded, there would be more fish to catch, which would be good for business and for conservationists. Those don't normally align. A study in Science from 2006 says if we don't do something, then by 2050, it doesn't matter. It's all over. We're gonna have no more fish to eat. All the populations will have collapsed. Under the PLOS Biology plan, each country could regulate its own 200 miles of fishing waters and thus maintain healthy populations of local fish and allow for the global population to rebound. Iceland, Australia, New Zealand, and the United States have already begun attempts to rebuild their fishing stock, but there is a lot more to do. Would this mean that you can't have sushi for a while? No, not really, but the sushi you might have may be more expensive, as only a small number of the fish will wander into those acceptable fishing areas for some of the fancier ones. Yes, there would be economic impact around the planet, but if we don't do something, we're on track to hunt fish to extinction. Go ahead, put your comment down below, and thanks a lot for watching DNews today. Subscribe for our daily videos 7 days a week.